raise everything up as high as we can reach without our heels leaving the floor. So I'm going to reach up high, reposition my handle, and then take my sling and do the same thing, putting it in the exact same loop on the adjustment strap. Remember, make sure both sides are equal. So when your sling is hanging, you want it to be, now this feels a little bit high to me. My arms are lengthened in doing this. So I'm going to drop it a little bit. I want the sling to be no higher than the crease in the fold of my thighs. So that way it makes it a lot easier to get in and out of, and I don't have to jump or struggle to get into the sling. So we're going to just bring it down a little bit. So that feels better. There we go. So positioning the foam at my back, I'm going to come in, and to get in, because it's higher, one of the easiest ways is to make the fabric nice and taut, like a tabletop, and just pushing down, hop in, and sign in, and bring the material right behind your knees. Now, because we're coming into full inversion, we want to manage our handles. We're going to take our longer handles this time and place them between the knees so that they stay out of the way and we don't smack us in the face. We're going to keep our middle handles available to us on the outside. And remember the importance of the foam. You want to place the foam against the sacrum. Lean forward a little bit, hold it in place, and begin to lean into the foam. Find your outside handles. Lean back with your upper body. Open your legs nice and wide. Draw towards your head. Into your diamond wrap. Step six is releasing the back of your hands to the floor. Take a nice deep breath and take a few moments just to relax and breathe through the adjustment phase. There's a lot of wonderful gentle stretches you can do here to deepen your pleasure. You can bring your hands behind your back, clasping your hands. Drop them towards the floor for a nice deep shoulder stretch. As you do this, assist the release of your back by drawing your one leg towards your spine and pressing into the soles of your feet. This helps to release the lower back and assist in the decompression of the spine. And then what I like to do is also give my neck a good stretch. So I'm going to rest my left hand and my lower back, take my right hand, and draw my right ear over to my shoulder. And just have a really nice stretch here. And then switch hands. Try to remember to always keep the belly drawing towards the spine to maintain the proper alignment in your pelvis. And a fun thing to do is just to twist a little bit side to side. You can take a hold of your lower handles even and just work out the spine. Move freely in any way you like. Just once again, move that cerebral fluid through the spine, assist the lymphatic system to drain, increase the circulation flow with your blood. And if you like, you can take a hold of your middle handles and bring them to the outside of your knees and toward your back. And moving the hands away from the body as you open your chest and down for a nice chest. So when you're ready to come back up, simply bring yourself around, bring the handles away from the sling, release your feet, unwrap them, and pull yourself up, coming up the same way you went down.